recently, there are a number of firms that appear to profit from protest. What determines when social activist challenges strengthen or weaken stakeholder support? Stakeholders are drawn to firms that share their values. Progressive movements tend to come to mind when you think about social movements. But conservative movements are out there, they're increasing, and they seem to play an equally important role in shaping corporate behavior.
The study, of course, problematizes this presumed relationship, I think, between social activism and firm performance, revealing that activism doesn't always result in declining performance.
We see the intersecting injustices that can take place when you have an unchecked spread of these market ideologies and these market systems. When we talk about, you know, like these market ideologies, what is this actually? So it's called marketization. And so technically speaking, marketization is this process by which we start to see, you know, like market logics and the policies that support markets, they start infiltrating our non-market arenas. And they eventually can displace non-market activities. And social movements that engage in demarketization are actually doing that work of deconstructing the market structures that are there with the goal of reconstructing a new system where those goods and services are provisioned in a way that's more socially environmentally just.
Caritas is an international Catholic organization. They started to focus their development issues, their social issues, like how are we gonna help these poor people in Brazil, looking more at empowering the community instead of just giving or donating money or food. Caritas is positive related, so they help the creation of solidarity economy enterprises. They are negative related with progressive Catholic Church. They become positive once there is this legitimacy.
Robustness or, you know, potentially even resilience as an outcome in the context of institutional complexity, I think is hugely important.